Members of Parliament has gone into a second day. Combative senior military officer Lieutenant General Peter Elwelu was one of them, and as combative and resolute as he is, he came up and spoke to reporters shortly after swearing in. He said US sanctions do not bother him and that every restriction that has been placed on him and other senior officers by the regime in Washington does not apply. General Elwelu came to the limelight after he commanded the UPDF in the insurrection in Kasese in 2016. Our reporter was there. Let's get the details of exactly what he said today.
I, Kiamonges William, swear in the name of the Almighty God that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to the Republic of Uganda, and that I will preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of Uganda. So help me God.
The inauguration ceremony of members of the 11th Parliament has entered day two, with 134 members taking oath. The UPDF Commander of Land Forces, Lieutenant General Peter Elwelu, was sworn in today to represent UPDF in the 11th Parliament.
I, Lieutenant General Peter Elwelu, swear in the name of the Almighty God that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to the Republic of Uganda, and that I will preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution. So help me God.
There is nothing tainted in my image. Do you see it tainted? I don't. There is nothing like that. There is, even ICC set me free, said, you have no case to answer. So what are you talking about?
Who killed the 200 people?
Those who are criminals. I haven't killed anybody innocent. Those who are, they deserved death.
The flamboyant three-star general says the U.S. sanctions do not intimidate him because he is not interested in traveling abroad. He insists that his actions in Kasese delivered peace in the area.
What is U.S.? And what are sanctions in your language? In our language, in Teso, there is nothing called sanctions. I don't understand it. I don't know what it means. And I don't know America. I know Uganda.
Meanwhile, several other MPs took oath, including Jinja City East MP Igema Naweta, who vowed that this time he has come to stay, having had his two consecutive terms in Parliament cut short by the courts of law. Naweta has had a bumpy career in Parliament and has never served beyond 2 years.
I'm here to stay. And especially, you see, and the most important thing for our people here is that I am a serious stakeholder in Gini. So I am there to stay. I am here to stay.
At 77, Finance Minister Matia Kasaija was sworn in to represent Buyanja County West for the fourth term. Kasaija told the press that unless his family decides otherwise, he is still in the game.
I, Matia Kasaija, swear in the name of the Almighty God that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to the Republic of Uganda, and that I will preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution. So help me God.
Is this your last time?
Oh, the last kitanja. We are seriously considering this issue with the family and with the constituents. But that would be my wish. But I tell you, circumstances may force, but if the circumstances as I'm predicting as they should be, I think I will stick to that word, that this should be my last concern.
Some opposition MPs who were sworn in today pledged to use this term in Parliament to discuss and legislate on presidential transition.
There's a lot that now we bring in. It was an opportunity for me to reflect and engage in the private sector, engage in the civil society, and work with the family. But the challenge ahead is still quite tough. This moment, our commitment is to really, as opposition, is to design a new framework so that we can move this country forward.
I really hope that by end of the 5 years, that we have had dialogue to discuss the transition government for this country.
The new legislators shared with us their plans, expectations, and the key priorities.
I was driving my campaign on a slogan that says Mbaira Omubiri. Exactly, this is what I'm going to be. So the kind of person in me that is going to be representing the people of Kaempe South is that person that is going to be taking on a hardline stance in terms of issues affecting our people.
When it comes to my area, a lot of people don't know what they have to play. Even their individual responsibilities have been gotten out of them. So as a leader, I want to make sure that we reorganize these people to come back to their senses and get reminded of their responsibilities as citizens.
My people in Chiboga, just be ready to receive me as somebody who is going to convene you, to mobilize you, to take part in all the planning that is required to take the district from one step to another. So, dear women, be ready to take charge.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news in Parliament.